Ukraine claims to have destroyed temporary Russian bridges with U.S.-made weapons to defend its incursion in the Kursk region. Kyiv has announced a string of battlefield successes since its unexpected cross-border attack on August 6. Ukraine has destroyed at least three bridges over the same river as it seeks to hold the pocket of captured land. Meanwhile, Moscow says its forces have halted Kyiv's advance in Kursk as it continues to gain ground in eastern Ukraine. Other headlines overseas, U.S. President Joe Biden speaks with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to discuss ways of advancing a potential Gaza ceasefire and hostage deal. The call follows the whirlwind trip of Secretary of State Antony Blinken to the Middle East that ended Tuesday without Israel and Hamas coming to an agreement. Blinken and mediators from Egypt and Qatar have pinned their hopes on a U.S. bridging proposal aimed at narrowing gaps between the two sides in the 10-month-old war. The White House will provide further details of the call later in the day, but Biden was expected to press Netanyahu to soften a new Israeli demand that it be allowed to keep forces along a stretch of land between Egypt and Gaza. Hamas is seeking a complete Israeli withdrawal from Gaza, including the so-called Philadelphia Corridor. Four bodies have been recovered aboard the sunken wreck of a luxury yacht belonging to the wife of British tech magnate Mike Lynch. The identities of the victims were not immediately given by authorities, but Britain's Daily Telegraph reports two of the dead were Lynch and his 18-year-old daughter. The search, meanwhile, continues for two missing people. Lynch had invited friends on the yacht to celebrate his recent acquittal in a U.S. fraud trial. The vessel was anchored off the Sicilian port of Porticello when it was hit by a storm and capsized early Monday. Only 15 of the 22 people on board managed to escape. The Obamas electrify the second night of the Democratic National Convention in Chicago with rousing endorsements of Vice President Kamala Harris and blistering attacks against Donald Trump. Our North America Bureau correspondent Henny Espinosa filed this report.
Hey guys, here are news-making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with the second night of the Democratic National Convention where the Obamas gave a rousing endorsement of Kamala Harris and gave a warning to Americans about Donald Trump.
Yeah!
On night two of the Democratic National Convention in Chicago, a symbolic roll call of delegates from the great states unanimously nominated Vice President Kamala Harris and Minnesota Governor Tim Walz for President and Vice President of the United States, announcing for Virginia the only Filipino-American serving in the U.S. Congress.
Mr. Secretary, the Commonwealth of Virginia is proudly represented by Senator Mark Warner and Senator Tim Kaine.
The Obamas gave memorable remarks to close out the DNC's second night.
For years, Donald Trump did everything in his power to try to make people fear us. See, his limited, narrow view of the world made him feel threatened by the existence of two hardworking, highly educated, successful people who happen to be black. I want to know, who's going to tell him that the job he's currently seeking might just be one of those black jobs?
If we each do our part over the next 77 days, if we knock on doors, if we make phone calls, if we talk to our friends, if we listen to our neighbors, if we work like we've never worked before, if we hold firm to our convictions, we will elect Kamala Harris as the next president of the United States.
Meanwhile, the DNC is seeing a record number of Filipino-American delegates.
This year's DNC witnessed a record number of 40 known fail-am delegates.
We're in making sure our voices are heard and that we are represented in the communities that we live in.
Not a lot of people have the chance to be the delegate to the national convention, especially this is going to be part of history. I'm going to be part of history if Kamala Harris become the president of the United States.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
A look now at what to expect on the third night of the Democratic National Convention in Chicago. Minnesota Governor Tim Walz is set to formally accept the party's nomination for vice president. Walz will deliver a speech to talk about growing up in Nebraska and the risks of another Trump presidency. Also on deck today, speeches from top Democrats, including former U.S. President Bill Clinton and Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg, former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, who was instrumental in persuading U.S. President Joe Biden to drop his struggling re-election bid, will also take the stage. Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump holds his first outdoor event since the attempt on his life last month. The U.S. Secret Service had approved a new plan for Trump to continue outdoor rallies in the wake of the July incident. At a rally in North Carolina, Trump accused the Biden administration of manipulating jobs figures after new data showed U.S. job growth has been far weaker than initially reported. He also asked the crowd if he should start getting personal following the attacks against him at the Democratic National Convention.
The new data from the Bureau of Labor Statistics shows that the administration padded the numbers with an extra, listen to this one, 818,000 jobs that don't exist. So they said they existed, and they never did exist. They built them up so that they could say what a wonderful job they're doing. No, we've never had numbers like this. They don't exist. Did you see Barack Hussein Obama last night? Take little shots. He was taking shots at your president. And so was Michelle. You know, they always say, sure, please stick to policy. Don't get personal. And yet they're getting personal all night long, these people. Do I still have to stick to policy?